One of the hardest things about a PAO surgery is being able to picture the three-dimensional anatomy in your mind while you're doing the surgery, because you're not looking directly at the bone you're cutting. So you're looking at a two-dimensional fluoro shot and you're trying to think in 3D.
So my first cut's the ramus cut, and I usually make it just right at this axilla, right in the axilla of the obturator foramen, so right. The next cut we make is gonna come down from here.
How do I make it stop dragging?
Say stop dragging.
Stop dragging. Genius. Okay, that's pretty freaking cool. Trying to drill this pin into the acetabular fragment. That's a pretty perfect pin. So I'm working on getting the chisel of this osteotome into our pre-planned cut.
It's cool because I can see through the obturator.
Yeah.
When we were making that very far ramus cut, I tried to do it without visualizing the bone surface that I was cutting, and I was able to slide that osteotome in under the skin and then see through the headset that I had the osteotome where I wanted it.
Well, does it look like I'm under the lip of the acetabulum?
Yes, you are.
No idea where my chisel is. This is where you really got to learn to trust your navigation.
In orthopedics, we use fluoroscopy all the time.
Normally with x-ray, I take a couple hits, I take an x-ray. I do a couple hits, I take an x-ray.
This is the first time I've ever done a PAO without any fluoro. What I learned today is that it's possible. This technology allowed me to see where my chisel was in 3D throughout.
Can you see it now?
Mm-hmm.
Pretty, pretty cool.
Yeah.
Now, are you making the final cut?
Making the posterior column cut, the fourth cut.
There are structures around the pelvis where you don't want to get near with your chisel blade. You can't see them. And so this is a new thing that now we can lean on a little bit to better understand where the chisel is and how to stay out of trouble.
Ooh, just freed up.
Yep.
You just felt it, huh?
Yeah.
You could hear it. It's like...
So I can finish this now.
Oh yeah, isn't that cool? Oh yeah.
Like we saw today, you can actually see it correcting in all the different planes of correction. I think it can prevent more inexperienced surgeons from misinterpreting the amount of correction they have that they see on their 2D fluoroscopy. So I think it can be a safety check for sure to make sure that you've put it where you think you put it.
Well, this is pretty historic here, Scott. This is like the first, you know?
Mm-hmm.
The best I can say right now is that it's exciting and promising, right? You guys are, you know, leaders in innovating, and we can put that to use in pediatric orthopedic surgery and hip surgery.